other?
You have tasted more of life than I can ever imagine. But your story has no end.
Do you know what it's like to live forever?
Your immortality has made you the greatest soldier of the Axon Cross in a war between our world and the next.
I've waited my entire life for the opportunity to help you.
Well, now's your chance.
Hello, everyone. This is Thomas Ray, our new guest this week. We're going to be talking about four new movies. Tonight is The Last Witch Hunter.
With Vin Diesel.
Vin Diesel, Rose Leslie, Elijah Wood, Michael Caine. And that's it. That's it. That's all I have to say about this movie.
What did you think about it?
So, The Last Witch Hunter.
Yes.
What is it about?
Vin Diesel saving the world from witches. Protecting the world from witches. Protecting and saving the world from witches.
Being beautiful.
Being beautiful while protecting the world and saving them from witches. The beautiful witch hunter.
Right. That's that.
The beautiful witch hunter. That's what it should have been called. Because he doesn't even use like weapons. He fights.
And he's using his phone so much.
He does use his phone.
Can you shut off your phone? We're watching a film.
Yeah.
We're gonna go over it. This is okay. Bobby the Bucket.
Okay.
We're gonna go over it. Like, people know what we do. We have questions. We're gonna go over them and talk about it.
I'm excited.
You are, me too.
I'm excited to talk about this movie.
Okay, hold on. I want you to pick, as your first time,
okay,
the first question.
This one.
This one?
This one.
Say it.
Backstory.
What's the backstory?
Okay, I was, I looked it up actually on Wikipedia as I was watching it.
Which sucks. If you have to look it up, it's because there's nothing going on in the movie.
This movie was bought from a long time ago. I'll explain it like this. Vin Diesel is a big Dungeons and Dragons fan.
Uh-huh.
So he wanted to do this movie because it reminded him of Dungeons and Dragons.
The video game.
Yeah, the game with the dice.
Yeah. Okay.
Big nerd stuff. So this big handsome man is a nerd, which is great for everybody. No, all right. And so I looked at that, and I also found out about the budget. Is there a question in there about the budget?
No, there is not.
They spent $90 million on this movie. Can you believe that?
I can't, because it sucks.
It was really bad.
As far as backstory, Tommy,
yeah.
Do you really think there's any backstories? Except the fact that we always see the woman, his wife and his kid,
yeah.
He goes in the past because he's suffering, blah, blah, blah. He can die and join her in heaven. Okay, that's great. Then what's going on?
It was a really bad Gladiator. Because in Gladiator, that's what happens,
that's
right?
Exactly. Goes back in time all the time in his head. And it's like, oh, flashback.
I think they saw like Gladiator and they were like, how can we do this with witches? And then that's what happened. I think that's what... But so he's the last... Dragon. I mean, they show you. He's the last witch hunter, man. Come on. He killed
the
last witch.
You know... I just don't know. Cinematography.
Okay. It was nice. A lot of good shots in New York, I think. No?
Yeah, there was. Yeah. They remind you it's shot in New York. But the photography, I actually like the photography.
Yeah, because it's $90 million.
In the flashback.
Yeah.
I like the photography in the very beginning.
In the very beginning, it was
medieval time or whatever.
You thought it was going to be a great movie from the beginning.
Right.
Right.
It starts, you're like, fuck, this shit is actually interesting. And then it gets really boring. And then I like the photography with the queen, the witch queen scenes.
Yes. She looks amazing.
Because of her makeup and stuff, it looks really awesome.
There's a scene where she's like in a tree.
That's great.
It's a great thing. And like she...
When she takes off.
Yeah.
Like she gets out of this...
that's dope.
Blind man's
body.
It's like...
It's like
so
great.
The photography is like in and out. It's really simple when it's like contemporary time,
yeah.
And it's like simple scenes. And when it gets to the back in the days, it's really interesting what they did.
I agree. But the present day stuff is awful.
It's just lame. Simple.
It's
you
like
know?
It's like there was a garbage fire and then they pulled that script out of the garbage
You're
fire.
You're meaner than I am. I like it.
That's well.
Vin Diesel. Talk about Vin Diesel. I'm just going to let you do this because I don't care enough.
He looked like he was being fed his lines through an earpiece the whole time. So he was just standing there, and he wasn't even emoting properly. He was just standing there being like, well, you know, things change.
No, deeper, deeper. So deeper and not even enunciating.
The witches, they do the things. And you're like, what are you talking about?
He doesn't even, like, make any choices. I was trying to think of one scene that I remember. And
no,
like,
remember, he got really angry at somebody. And then he slammed his hand down.
They probably didn't give him a coffee right before the take. They were like, no, this is not happening. Used it for the take, and that's it. That's the only choice.
I'd rather have seen Vin Diesel cashing the check from this movie than watch this movie.
That's hilarious.
I'd rather have seen him sign the check.
And you know what's hilarious? It's like during the scene with Michael Caine, you're like, you're acting off of Michael Caine. Can you just pay attention to what he's doing and answer? Or like just have fun with Michael Caine. He's not listening to Michael Caine.
There are two different two different places. Michael Caine does it for the money and you'll appreciate it. You'll be like, Michael Caine, I appreciate you in this terrible movie because you were giving it. Yeah. Vin Diesel was in there just there.
He's chilling.
He's not doing anything.
He's not doing anything. The script.
It's awful. It was, I had high expectations from Wikipedia for this. I keep saying Wikipedia because that's the most interesting thing about it. Like reading what happened. This was like a widely regarded script that they got from somewhere that they just destroyed. And they just took their time to like make it not happen. You know what pissed me off about this movie? I'm gonna tell you this. I'm gonna tell you what happened.
Go.
What pissed me off. After the flashback sequence in the very beginning, when he meets that stewardess, right? And then he comes, right.
I forgot about that scene.
But
Jesus.
Remember, she comes down in the elevator and walks out. Like,
And that's it. They fucked. We just fucked.
How dare you not give that, that's it. He's a playboy. And living on a plane, he like takes the ruins out and she's like, he tells the witch, he's like, do you know you shoved this in
deeper.
Your bag? You shoved this in your bag.
Like, I don't understand any words he's saying.
I didn't understand that whole scene. Like, everything just from that point.
I think I fell asleep or I was texting someone during that scene. Yeah. Because I don't remember any single lines of this.
I only remember because I was up and I just kept thinking to myself, I was like, we could all do this. Like, we can all be actors. Because that's something that I couldn't believe that somebody was just like, okay, that was a good take, and they walked away. How do you do that? How do you do that?
The director, Breck Eisner.
Eisner?
Eisner.
Congratulate that man. He got a paycheck for doing nothing. I congratulate you, sir. And it's great. Good for him.
What's next? The second one?
They greenlit a second one, and then after this movie didn't make any money, they.
They're not editing.
I mean.
Too long.
It was very long.
And now we're in 46 minutes, and it still felt like way too long.
Last Witch Hunter 2, Last Witch Hunter again.
They should just make a witch movie about the witch. She's great.
If they did a prequel with the witch, that would
be
awesome.
Do just a witch queen sequel. Yeah. Like, that's, I care about her. Come back to life. It makes no sense, but come back to life. I just want to see you.
The prequel could be called The Witch Hunter, and just Vin Diesel's in it for 2 minutes, and then it's just about the
cameo.
Witch.
Cameo. Just show up, say hi, and that's it.
I read a lot about Vin Diesel during this movie because I wanted to know like what his life was like because of this, and it's pretty good. He's a pretty good life.
I mean, nothing, like, I'm sure everything is perfect about his life. Like, at him, like, how lucky this guy is.
That must be nice. You get to make a garbage movie for $90 million, and then you just, like, that's it? And then you go on to Fast 18? I don't know.
Visual effects.
Great.
I'm gonna brag, but the witch scenes were the best.
You like the witches? Okay, so what about the guy who's the bad guy who was like doing the thing where he was,
with the butterflies?
Not the blind guy, the other one who had like the beard.
I have no idea who that guy was.
Who was he?
I thought it was Hagrid from Harry Potter.
Yeah.
And then I was like, no, this is not Harry Potter. And then he talks shit and I don't know what he's saying. And then I'm like, are you the bad guy? Who are you working for? I was so confused. I mean, I was so distracted. So I was like, I need to pay attention more to know what's going on. And I was not like, I just don't know who he was.
There's a part where like Vin Diesel reaches for him through a hole and like pulls out half his.
That was nice.
What was this, his beard?
I don't know. It was way too quick. The shot is way too quick.
Strange.
Look how confusing this is. Like this is now. Like, thank you so much.
I'm confused.
So the visual effects were great.
They were great. They were tremendous. I loved it. Once again, thank you so much, Batman. Whoever or lady, whoever did the visual effects was great.
The cast. So let's go over the cast.
Okay.
Did you like? So Vin Diesel. Thank you so much. Elijah Wood.
I don't know what he was doing in this movie. Do you have any clue what he, like the twist on him in the end and stuff like that? What is even?
Did, I don't know.
Were they doing rewrites as they were doing the movie?
They did. I feel like they did. They were like, you know what? No. You know what? You know what? I think you love the queen. And you're gonna fight for this. And he dies after like 10 seconds. He doesn't have anything to say. She's like, he goes in the air, flies, and he dies. And I'm like, I love Julie Engelbrecht.
Yes.
She's playing the witch queen, and she's French. Bonsoir. Oh my God, she's so good. She was so good. I think she was amazing. Like, she looks like shit.
Yeah.
She's so committed to the character.
Yes.
She's like, she's so evil and angry, and I understand her like, she's so good. And this movie was actually her Hollywood debut, so it sucks. This movie sucks, but you know what? Go, Julie.
You talking about Michael Caine?
Michael Caine, chilling. I think chilling, like, just being like, he did what he can do best. Just being...
chill,
Michael Caine. Old and awesome.
Yeah, you're just being Michael Caine throughout the whole thing. It's so even. He's just like sitting there.
I felt like he was like, what's his face in The Dark Knight?
He was Alfred.
Right, I felt like he was kind of that.
Always Alfred. Yeah.
He's like, I'm just going to be Alfred for the rest of my life.
You know, that's why he got it. They were like, okay, well, you know, we get Michael Caine in here and he's going to be great.
He's like, do you know we're not shooting another Batman movie? He's like, he's so funny. No, but like, clearly, I think he thought he was doing Alfred.
You sign the checks, he will be there.
So, sound mixing and the editing of the sound.
I mean, they could have...
remember anything about it.
Yeah, Vin Diesel was terrible. His voice. So, I'm sure he was lower and they raised him up. And that's the issue.
Can you please speak up? Shit. Like, you know what I mean?
The 27th take.
The boom operator was like, I don't know what the fuck he's doing. He probably had a mic in his mouth to pick up the sound for the dialogue.
Yeah.
I mean, good job, you guys, for doing an amazing job with the sound. Last one is love interest.
I did not know that she was going to be the love interest until...
What? It happens so... In the bar when they meet, it's like, oh, he's going to want her. And he's going to... She's going to want her. It was so obvious to me. But they never kiss because they obviously don't look like a couple.
Yeah.
Like a Hollywood couple. They're like, we don't need you guys to kiss. We got it.
And he already had sex earlier in the movie, so he didn't
with
need
a stewardess that looks like her-ish. Yeah. This is such a weird movie.
The question is I have is, was this like a thing? Were these demands that were met in the movie? It was like, so I need to bang in the movie. So we're going to have that up top. Everybody's got to know their own Playboy. And then after that...
He's like, we need to know I'm a womanizer, right? If not, I'm not doing this film.
I've been around for 500 years, guys. This is what happens. It happens like that. I didn't think about that. They don't kiss.
They don't kiss. They look at each other like, we are about to kiss, but we're not kissing. At the end, she says like, you're gonna miss me. I'm gonna miss you. Blah, blah, blee, blah. Yeah. Bollocks, bollocks. And that's it. And then they never freaking kiss. And I'm like, can you guys at least like, you know, like just do like a little chilly romantic thing going on?
That would have been nice, but there wasn't even that.
Like touch his cheek, very cheesy with violin in the back. I'd be like, ah! But at least like it would happen. But like here, there's nothing.
He's too tough. He's too tough. The character's too
tough. He's not too tough.
He's too tough.
I'm sure he's not too tough. So now we're gonna kind of conclude.
It was bad. But you know. It was made.
It was made.
It's a thing.
It was bad, but it was made. It's gonna be sold.
Hey, have you seen The Last Witch Hunter? Crowd leaves.
Yeah, right. Oh, I'll unfriend you on Facebook for saying that. Okay, well, thank you so much, you guys. I hope you appreciated it. That was Thomas Ray. He's gonna be here again for 3 other reviews. This is Like It or Not, all right? Like It or Not. So if you don't like it, or not. I like this guy. He's really fun.
This guy's cool.
Nah, can be. Say bye.
You're a dreamwalker. Get out. I need you. to the dream world. It's the only way to fight what's coming.
If you die in there, you die out here. And I need you to wake up. You are in a trap!
Yeah, you're not qualified for what happens next. Powerful witches that ever walked the earth are here to destroy us.
And so it begins.
There's some very bad things out there.
Who says that a witch can't hunt witches?